Hello everyone, welcome back. Let's talk about physical AI, AI world model, simulation, and AGI. The thing that you're looking right now is AI female robot, humanoid girl robot, and it was presented on TES 2025 recently. So let's cover some robots. And I personally believe that those robotics will be crucial to achieve AGI. So as you can see, this robot costs $175,000 and it's very expensive, and it's really important because even if it's so expensive, that means that you can buy it today in 2025. So what's happening? Google is building its own world model AI team, predominantly they saying for games and robot training. Let's dig deeper what that means. World models are relatively new development within AI, kind of, that could serve a variety of purposes, such as real-time interactive media environments. So basically it's games and training other applications, training other robots. Google is creating a platform, something similar to Nvidia, what I'm going to cover in a second. And the reason why Google is doing this is because they think that this is crucial to achieve AGI. We believe scaling pre-training on video and multimodal data is on the critical path to AGI. That means that the data for training those foundational models, multimodals, is not only text, audio, images, videos, but they need all this data to create the physical world, for the models to understand the physical world. And they're talking about the simulation. So the platform can simulate the physical world for training embodied agents, which means robots. And that autonomous AI agents may start to meaningfully join workforces this year. Wow, this is huge. So basically that means that in 2025, we're going to have robots working in factories or in workplaces among humans. It's going to start with small amount, but then it's going to be ramping up. I'm going to later on cover Elon's Tesla plan about that Optimus bot, and you're going to see the numbers. It's also worth to say that Amazon actually invests tons of money in robotic workforce. Actually, let's quickly check Amazon robot workforce, and you can see that if you obviously trust Google AI, it's already nearly 1 million robots in warehouses collaborating with humans. So going back to Nvidia 6th of January launched the Cosmos platform, which is the world foundation model platform to accelerate physical AI development, basically AI robots. And physical AI models are costly to develop and require vast amount of real world data and testing. Yes, it's super expensive for physical AI, and Tesla is the number one leading company in this, thanks to their massive 5 or 6 million fleet of Tesla cars that has 8 cameras, and they're all connected to internet, to their data center, and gather this data. So when I was talking about the simulations and testing, this is what Nvidia also planned to give to everyone else, other car makers, other applications with like robots. Offer developers an easy way to generate massive amounts of photoreal, physics-based, synthetic data to train and evaluate their existing models. This is actually crucial, synthetic data. Do you know that actually last year, we ran out of data to train foundational models, the biggest models like GPT-5, Claude 4, Grok 3. Last year, actually, you know, imagine the amount of data. So we're talking about indexing and crawling all the internet, all forums, all websites, news, all books, all videos on YouTube. Well, nobody will confirm that they scrap and index the videos, but this is what happened. So we ran out of data to train those models last year, and basically synthetic data is the new king of data. And Nvidia is planning to support the physical world of video generating simulations to train and test the models. Cosmos models will be available under an open model license to accelerate the work of the robotics, robots, and autonomous vehicles, cars. So if you think about it, what Nvidia is saying is that we are in a ChatGPT moment, but for robots. So this is like an iPhone moment for mobile and internet. It's saying that like large language models, world foundational models, the new model, world foundation physics, are fundamental to advancing robots and autonomic vehicles development. Yet not all developers have the expertise and resources to train their own. That's why Nvidia is addressing the gap of the market. So we've got a physics-based photoreal synthetic data generation. And what I want to say here is that if you think about the consequences and what that means, that we are very close to actually creating a simulation, like a multiverse. And this is really interesting because obviously Nvidia is talking about the business to empower the applications, other developers. However, we are very close, closer and closer for simulation theory. So this is how the CEO of Nvidia presented on the robots, how they're investing in it. So those are the demos, a presentation. You can see those little ones from similar to movie WALL-E or Star Wars droids. And I believe it's super cool. All right, whilst we are on Nvidia, it's really cool to say that the new RTX 50 series offers similar level performance to 4090. However, it's 3 times cheaper. And that means that everyone, literally everyone, can have access to a GPU that's capable of running locally AI models and to run inference for robots, for your applications, for your own LLMs locally, multi-models. And yeah, this is 2025. Okay, now let's talk about Tesla Optimus Bot, because I personally believe, and I'm gonna bet, that this robot gonna be the winner. And there are 3 reasons because of that. First is the cost. It's gonna cost half of the Tesla car. So we're talking about $20,000, $25,000, $30,000 per robot. Second, data and training capacity. Tesla have got the most real physics, real world data right now because of this massive fleet of 5-6 million Tesla cars out there in the world with 8 cameras, gathering this data, sending to Tesla Gigafactory, whatever they want to get all the edge cases for their training. And the third reason is manufacturing capability. Tesla have got their own Gigafactories all around the world, Asia, Berlin, Texas, and they do manufacturing for 15 plus years, comparing to all other companies. Think about it. Nvidia is the biggest company, you know, right now, nearly $4 trillion market cap. However, they don't have a physical factory. They don't own factories. Tesla does. Now let's talk about, go back to AGI. And this is the website of livearchitect.ai, Dr. Allan's. He's got the conservative countdowns to AGI. And I believe it's the most accurate prediction and countdown to AGI. When I first started checking it, it was around 20%. Now we're sitting on 88% probability to achieve AGI. And there are various definitions of AGI. However, one of the things is it's crucial to have embodiment, the physical robots to achieve AGI, or at least to have that model underlying this AGI, understand the physical world. So Dr. Allan updates this website very often, for example, in January, it bumped up to 88% because of this exactly Nvidia Cosmos platform for robots. And there are 14 humanoid robots shown. And also he adds side notes, for example, OpenAI CEO, Sam Altman, quote, We are now confident we know how to build AGI as we have traditionally understood it. And I'm going to explain it in a second. We believe that in 2025, we may see the first AI engines. Wow, okay. So some people think that AGI is a multimodal agent. Some people think that it's a physical embodiment. I think it's a blend. And all the industry is aiming for AI agents, like the applications, the businesses. AI agent you can think of Slack AI bot, where you can have a chat with, give tasks, links to Jira tickets, upload files in a conversation, etc. However, to achieve the better economic output, because that's the definition of AGI, in my opinion. Like, if we have a greater economic output from this AI agent than typical human, this is the moment when we're going to achieve AGI. So I believe, you know, the AGI we can call a robot that will have better or equivalent economic output as a human being. I believe we're already seeing this a little bit in software. And this year, we're going to start seeing this in factories. Right. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. If you have any comments, I will engage in comments to answer any questions, and see you in the next one.